So this movie right here, The Tomorrow War, starring Chris Pratt. As you can see, there's a difference in the audience and the critics, which, again, we've seen this time and time again. We've seen this over and over again, a difference between the audience and the critics. The critics don't seem to understand what the audience is looking for. The critics often are trashing something that the audience seems to find a lot of enjoyment. So I, based on the recommendation of Yellow Flash, because Yellow Flash sent out a tweet basically saying The Tomorrow War is solid. Okay, so I decided I am going to watch this movie. And let me tell you right now, I absolutely enjoyed the hell out of this movie. I thought it was fantastic. Now, again, it's a dumb popcorn-esque film. So don't think that I'm giving you this, it's an all-time great movie. It's a fun, dumb kind of popcorn movie, but it has some heart to it. And one thing that stood out to me was it allowed fathers to shine. It allowed dads to shine and to step up and not get crushed, you know, by the all-powerful women. Now, again, don't get me wrong. Is there a little bit of probably, I don't even want to say it's identity politics. It's clear that they were going, you know, kind of a little overboard on like making sure we have women in it. But these women actually belonged in their roles, you know, and they were believable and it was earned. And it wasn't because they weren't just there to trash the men. But Chris Pratt was phenomenal. Chris Pratt was awesome. And it's just funny, you know? It's just funny that they just trashed this movie when it's like, to me, I think Gary said this, because I think Gary watched it last night too. I think I saw a tweet from Gary, and he's basically like, it's no Starship Troopers, but it's really good. And I think that's kind of the mindset that you have to go into if you're going to watch this movie. You need to understand that it's not Starship Troopers, okay? It's not, which nothing is, because Starship Troopers is amazing. But it's kind of got that vibe to it. You know, it's got good personalities. Chris Pratt's obviously the top person in it, and he carries it. You know, if Chris Pratt wasn't in this, I'm not sure I would have watched it. But I really did enjoy this movie. Again, it's kind of dumb popcorn fun, which is kind of what we need right now. And I really enjoyed it. I really did enjoy it. J.K. Simmons is in it. J.K. Simmons is awesome as well. And yeah, I would highly recommend that anyone that was on the fence on this movie, highly recommend that you check it out. Go into it understanding that it's not going to be the greatest movie you've ever seen. It's kind of just dumb fun with some heart. There is heart in this movie, and there's a level of there's some emotional levels, you know, that are definitely explored in the movie. But the fact that you see this divide, I mean, clearly the fans like it. Why? Because it's an enjoyable film and it's not drowned out by identity politics and bullshit. You know, that's all we're looking for. That's all we're looking for. You know, it celebrates families. It celebrates fathers. And it has some really entertaining, you know, storytelling. And that's all it was. That's all it was. Justin Normie says it made me teary-eyed. And I totally understand that. There were some really good moments. And if you're a father, then you probably will kind of get a couple of gut punches in this movie. But overall, the fact that the critics are trashing it and the fans are loving it, it pretty much tells you all you need to know. This is the world we live in now, where most of these critics judge movies based on identity politics and what type of narrative is in it. And if it's just one of those things that they just don't like it. And it's so funny to watch them go against it. But I enjoyed it. I really enjoyed it. And again, shout out to Yellow Flash for that. I'm not sure I would have watched it if it wasn't for Yellow Flash saying like it's solid. And it is. It's solid. You know, again, not the greatest movie you're ever going to see in your life. Not going to blow you away. I think I would watch it again. I would watch it a second time. No, I'm not talking spoilers. No spoilers. No spoilers, Tugs. I have not said any spoilers. But it's, yeah. I would recommend it as a dumb, fun popcorn film. And Chris Pratt, you know, with his star power, definitely keeps it elevated for sure. If Chris Pratt wasn't in it, Would I have seen it? Probably not. But I also probably wouldn't have seen it if the critics weren't trying to say that it's this horrific thing. Again, they'll give Ghostbusters 2016 better reviews than this. You know, it's just absolutely ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. So go support Chris Pratt, someone who's far too good for Hollywood. He's far too good for Hollywood. He really is. And I absolutely recommend this movie.